Hi traders, welcome to the weekly Forex overview brought to you by Admiral Markets. My name is Chris, and the focus of course on the euro dollar, pound dollar, and dollar yen. Will there be a breakout or a bounce? We'll discuss that in this video. First of all though, be aware that this video is shown to a global audience but may not be suitable for everyone. Please visit admiralmarketsglobal.com, select your country of residence, and contact an appropriate entity to find out if it is suitable for you. Also, please note that trading for exchange and global financial markets is considered high risk. Please seek the advice of an independent financial advisor for more information on that. This webinar is for informational and educational purposes only. By continuing watching this video, you are aware of the risk involved and you agree with this risk disclaimer. Let's kick off this video with the euro dollar weekly chart. Last week, we had a bullish candle breaking above the resistance trend line, and it seems that there could be a continuation just based on that kind of breakout. There's a little bit of wick at the end of last week, but I do think that the formation is looking bullish at the moment. If it stays above 117.25, if it were to break below that, there might be some downside pressure towards 116.50, maybe 116, and even down to 115. For the moment though, if it stays above support, there could be basically on a lower time frame a break pullback continuation, and that's what seems to be happening right now. Today's daily candle would be a good measurement of whether price is bouncing or not. Basically, price at the moment, a large wick at the bottom, and is staying above the weekly pivot point. But if it does close anywhere around 117.25 or lower, then I think the bulls definitely have to be careful of a turnaround. I think in that case, a bearish candle, bearish daily candle today could create some more downside pressure. As I said, towards those levels, put max 115, 114.70 in mind. So, but if today is something like this, right, with a wick at the bottom, preferably even a bullish candle close, I think that there's a good chance that in the next couple of days, there will be at one moment that bullish breakout up to the R1 and perhaps even the R2, and maybe even to the R3 and previous top. All right, so that could be the bullish potential there on the euro dollar. If it does break to the upside, these targets could be envisioned for the rest of the week, and there could be some continuation of this uptrend as we go along. One of those signals could be on a 4-hour chart to look at the breakout above this resistance trend line. You can see already that price bounced off of the support zone I just mentioned at 117.25 at the 61.8 fib. Now looking for a breakout basically. Let's see if this candle holds. This could be a retracement of this strong 4-hour candle. If it stops again at the weekly pivot point, there could be a inverted head and shoulders right there. Look at the blue lines that I'm drawing right there. That could be it. So this is the left shoulder, the head, and the right shoulder. So if price were to retrace there, bounce, and then break, that could be a signal of an upside too, even on this time frame. And you can see that maybe even a little bit better on the hourly time frame. So that's what I'm expecting for the euro dollar. We'll be keeping an eye on the euro dollar, of course, in Nenet's session on Monday and Tuesday. Wednesday, we have more trading webinars, in fact. So, of course, euro dollar is definitely on the list to review, plus some other currency pairs and instruments. So join those webinars. Thursday, we're taking a look at equities and CFDs. And, of course, each day, there's also real-time trading ideas, 15-minute webinar in the morning. All right, pound dollar did have a breakout here, pullback, and made a continuation. However, overall, it is still going sideways. It is still in a range, and price is respecting both the resistance and the support levels, plus there are support trend lines coming in from the left here as well. So basically, caught in a sideways movement for the moment, and we're looking for a bigger breakout on the daily chart. A daily breakout candle is what I'm looking for, above support or below resistance. For the moment, this price has broken above this resistance trend line and is making its way up to the top of that zone, which, for my opinion, is, if anything, more of a bouncing reversal spot that could take price back to the weekly pivot point, maybe even down to the support trend lines, the S1 and the bottom of the range, if it were to extend, or it might even bounce and then extend. So for the moment, it could definitely continue. This range might just stay intact and price might just go sideways for the time being. Eventually, yes, there will be a breakout, but my time frame of choice for such a breakout is the daily chart. So unless I see a good daily breakout candle, I will not be trading any breakout up or down above resistance, and I'm talking about this resistance zone or below this support zone on lower time frames. With regard to the dollar yen, basically has finally made its continuation lower. It was very slow and really tested the patience of us traders, but finally did make the turn. And it's something we've been talking about already for a long time, of course, how price is basically at resistance. Sorry, I should use red. And that it'll be probably difficult for price to break that. We should expect a bounce, and that bounce happened. It just turned so slow and so correctively that it's not easy to trade. But yes, finally, if you had that patience to stay in, basically price indeed falling towards the 38.2 Fib, which in fact could be kind of a first bouncing spot as well. Just like the 23.6 Fib was a bouncing spot, the 38 could be the same. But I'm expecting a deeper move down. I think that the 38.2 Fib will create a correction that might go back to the weekly pivot point, might go back to these bottoms, might go back to the top of this channel. But ultimately, I think there could be a strong resistance zone, and that could send price back down to challenge lower Fibs like the 50. And what is that 50 Fib? It's basically putting a Fib from this swing high bottom to this swing high top. And basically, what I'm looking at here is a retracement, 23.6, then 38, and I'm expecting price to go to the 50, maybe even to the 61.8 Fib before bouncing to the upside. All right, so that's basically the dollar yen at the moment. I think there is a potential bounce, maybe not right here. There is a little bit of a space left, and I think there could be, you know, one more push down to 111.80-ish before maybe we get, or 75 before we get that retracement. It's just not a lot of space before potential bounce, and this should be corrective, does occur, and then price, I would expect, will continue lower. Of course, if it breaks above the weekly pivot point and it breaks above 112.60, there could be a bullish breakout to the R1 and maybe to the R2 as well. But for the moment, I think higher chance of a bearish bounce at 112.50. All right, that wraps it up for the moment. Check out admiralmarkets.com for more analysis, more webinars, more articles, more info about getting some of these indicators that you saw on my chart. MT4 plugin, Supreme Edition plugin with 60 extra features. So a lot of good stuff there. Check it out at admiralmarkets.com, and wish you all good trading. Cheers.